Oh, there we go. Okay, whenever you're ready. Start on our. You take a nice, take a seated position, however you're comfortable, either cross-legged, you sit on your knees. If you have a block or a blanket, feel free to prop yourself up on that. Some people like that. Really get rooted down in your sit bones. Sit up, try to create length in your spine. Bring your chest forward and let your shoulders drop back. You can let your hands fall to your over your knees, or you can let them just lay in your lap, whatever's most comfortable to you. And invite you to close your eyes. Start to come to stillness. Start to become aware of your breath, your natural breath. Watching your inhales and your exhales. At the end of every inhale starts an exhale. Notice after every exhale, notice the breath that flows over the top of your lip. You might notice any sensations arising within your body, your mind. Just simply let your thoughts be there, observe them, the non-reactive mind, no judgment. Always come back to your breath. Notice yourself getting stuck in a thought. Just simply notice it. Don't judge it. Let it be. Honor that's where you're at. And start again. at this time when our lives are all changed and we're out of our routines, we need to use these moments to find stillness and reach within ourselves despite our anxieties and fears. These are the moments when you come back to your breath. Slowly back to your slowly bring your awareness back. Still focusing on your breath. We bring our arms up for length. We're going to slowly turn to your right and place your left hand on your right knee. And your right hand behind your back and just looking over your right shoulder for a slight twist. And come back up through center, your left arms lift for length and twist to the other side. Right hand will come on your left knee. You'll look over your left shoulder. Feel that stretch in your side. You can do it a couple more times. Bring some movement back into your body. And then come back, come onto our hands and knees. And have you lift your right arm up. You're gonna thread it under your left arm. You're gonna come down. Your right cheek should face the mat. Keep your arm right in place here, your left arm. And the different variations are if you want a little bit more, deeper, you can send it out and really feel that stretch, or you can place it behind your back for even deeper, or simply let it be. I'll stay here for a couple minutes. Thank you. focused on your breath. Each breath just melt further in. Slowly back up out of the position into the tabletop, slower than you'd like. Sink your hips back onto your toes into child's pose for a counter pose. You can keep your arms extended out in front of you, or you can let them lay along your sides. But just be, just sit and feel sensations in your body. Bring yourselves back up into the tabletop position. Put your hands on your knees. Extend your left arm all the way up. And slowly thread it under your right arm, placing your left cheek onto the mat. Again, you can leave your right arm right there. You can extend it out long, or you could wrap it behind your back. Whatever works in your practice. Feel the stretch through your shoulder. Thank you. watching your breath, your inhales and your exhales. Let your breath be your guide. Very slowly start to come out. Put yourself back into child's pose. Take your hips back. Being still. Slowly bring yourself down onto your belly. From here, we're going to pop yourself up onto your forearms. Go into Sphinx. You should feel the sensation in your lower back. Try to lift your chest. You can let your head drop. That's more comfortable. The block, you can also place the foot on the block. Practice. Extend your arms. long, straighten your arms out. You're gonna come up for a deep breath. Stretch your lower back. Yourself getting lost, getting stuck in some thoughts, that's okay. Just come back, start again. It's so easy to get stuck in our fears right now. I saw a beautiful quote recently. It said, "I have not ceased being fearful, but I have ceased to let fear control me." I think we can tend to get caught up in that. And that's okay. But we can use our breath to calm us and bring us back. Slowly lower down onto your mat and just lay. Place your cheek to the mat. Be in stillness. Resisting any urges, just shake out. Slowly come back up the tabletop. Bring yourself back up onto your hands and your knees. And take a few little stretches here. Let your belly drop. Let your chin lift up. Your little cat and cows here. And then exhale. Round your back. Up your chin. Another inhale, let your belly drop. Yeah. Your exhale, round your back. We're going to set up for our next. You bring your right knee behind your right wrist and your right foot behind your left wrist. We'll set up for sleeping swan. Try to square off, let your left leg come long behind you. Square off and sit up for length. And slowly lower down either onto your forearms. If it's in your practice, you can come all the way flat onto your stomach. Thank you. practice is purposefully uncomfortable. It's meant to take you to your edge. That place, your edge, the place where if you went too far, it'd be too much. But any less is not enough. In our lives right now, we are being tested, being asked to remain home with limitations, and any less wouldn't be enough. Simply come back to your breath. Back to the hands and knees. Stretch your leg out behind you. Or you can come up to downward dog, whatever feels best in your body. Stretch out that leg. Slowly come back down into your hands and knees. We'll set up for the left side. Bring your left knee behind your left wrist and your left foot behind your right ankle. Your left foot behind your right wrist. Let your right leg go long behind you. Square off your hips. Sit up for length. Slowly, very slowly, let it come down onto your forearms or all the way down onto your chest, whatever's been your practice. Thank you. So being with ourselves and our thoughts and our anxieties, our fears. This is the test, the real test. How we will react when we are vulnerable and afraid. Being vulnerable and still doing the right thing, facing that fear. That is what real courage is. We need to find the courage to be uncomfortable. Not only the physical discomfort, also the mental discomfort. Remember, quote, I have not ceased being fearful, but I have ceased to let fear control me. Very slowly coming back up, slower than you'd like. Bring yourself back up onto your hands and your knees, extending your leg out from behind you, or bring yourself into downward dog, whatever feels right within your body. To seated, extend your legs out in front of you. Just sit, feeling any sensations that might be arising, letting them, just feeling. Slowly bring your soles of your feet together, let your knees fall wide.
Broken down that entire. I'm living life on the merry-go-round. You can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Ooh, mountain. We gon' walk it out. Ooh, mountain. And I'll rise up, I'll rise up, I'll rise up, and I'll rise up, and I'll rise up. The silence isn't quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe. I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet. Ooh, mountain, bring it to its feet. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And for that we have each other. And we will rise, we will rise, we will rise. Oh, we'll rise. I'll rise up, rise like the day. I'll rise up in spite of the end. I will rise a thousand times again. And we'll rise up, I like the waves. We'll rise up in spite of the ache. We'll rise up, and we'll do it a thousand times again.
Slowly, very slowly, put yourself all the way back up, going through your one vertebrae at a time, sitting back up your legs. Let your legs come straight out in front of you. You can place your arms behind you and take a nice stretch back. Let your head drop back. Take your knees and you can windshield wipe them side to side. Slowly come back down onto your back. Bring your knees into your chest. Give yourself a nice hug. Roll, rock side to side. Let your arms fall along to a T. And let your knees fall to the right. And your head could drop to the left. Slowly bring your knees back to center. Give yourself another hug. Arms fall wide again. And let your knees fall to the left. Let your head turn to the right. So I'm going to share something that I had seen more recently, and I thought it was really beautiful. It says, "History will remember when the world stopped and the flights stayed on the ground and the cars parked in the street and the trains didn't run. History will remember when the schools closed and the children stayed indoors and the medical staff walked towards the fire and they didn't run. History will remember when the people sang on their balconies in isolation, but so very much together, in courage and song. History will remember when the people fought for their old and their weak, protected the vulnerable by doing nothing at all. History will remember when the virus left and the houses opened and the people came out and hugged and kissed and started again, kinder than before." We will all be stronger and we will all be kinder. And love will get us through. back to center. Yourself another hug. Take any final movements or stretches your body feels it may need. Maybe a happy baby. Maybe you need to step down long. Whatever your body needs. This is your practice. Let your legs fall long. Let them fall wide. Let your hands fall wide, arms fall wide. Start to melt into your mat. Let your shoulders relax. Jaw relax. Face. Let your mind come to ease. Just be. Take rest. Savasana. Start to bring some awareness back into your body. Slowly moving some of your fingers, wiggling your toes. Maybe taking a nice stretch over your head. Bringing your knees into your chest, giving yourself a nice big hug. Roll over to either side into a fetal position. Slowly coming back up to a seated position. Bringing your hands to heart center. This is where we'll send out our metta. We send out love, gratitude to all the nurses and doctors and essential personnel. They're out there right now putting themselves on the line. And may all beings everywhere be healthy and healed. May all beings be happy and find peace. Let's take a nice deep breath. Fill all the way up. Let your mouth drop open. Take a nice deep exhale. The love, the light, divinity within me honors the love, the light, and the divinity in each and every one of you. Namaste. Thank you.
Thank you.
Namaste. Thank you so much, Erin.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you so much for being here. Glad I could do this.